You might have heard your lecturers talk to you about journal articles. If not your lecturer, then you might have had your academic librarian come in to talk to your class and mention them at that point. And you might be thinking, well, what is a journal article? And what's so important about it? Why do I need to use it? This video is going to give you the basic information you need to know why they're so important to your academic work. So if you're not sure what a journal article is, think about a magazine. A magazine generally has a subject focus, which contains articles that are related to that subject. But within that, there are a variety of different authors who are contributing to the magazine. Each issue will have an issue number or a name. It might be the September issue, or it might be the summer issue, for example. And within each magazine, there are page numbers to help you navigate through the articles via a contents page. An academic journal is very similar to a regular magazine because it also has a subject focus. Within each issue are articles, which are written by a variety of authors. They have volume and issue information, perhaps not quite as descriptive as a magazine. It might be numbers like volume 43, issue 2, for example, but they're there nonetheless. And again, to help you navigate each issue, there are page numbers. So while a magazine is generally very readable by anybody and is of interest to anybody, an academic journal is written for academics and professionals within that field, as well as students like yourself, to help you develop your learning and your knowledge on that subject. So a journal article is one of these articles within the academic journal. So the picture here is showing you some print journals. You're much more likely to access these in a digital format these days. But again, if you imagine that magazine and think, well, I'm reading this online, it's just like reading the web page with an article from a magazine, from a popular magazine. It's just that it's academic content that's related to your field of study. So what are they actually for then, these academic journals and the articles that are within them? Generally, academic journal articles are publishing research papers, the results of up-to-date research within that relevant field that the journal is written about. They inform professionals within each field of study of new advancements, new knowledge that's been developed and discovered. And practitioners within each academic field will use them to make professional decisions. A consultant in a hospital, for example, will go and search the relevant journal articles to find out how they can best support the patients that they are treating. Therefore, it's important that you, as students, use them as well, because you will be expected to use them once you are a qualified professional in whatever field you are studying to go into. So let's now think about the kinds of research that you might find within these journal articles. They report on a range of types of research. So there might be primary research. This is when the researchers have carried out experiments. They've conducted surveys or made observations and done interviews to find out the data themselves. Or it might be secondary research, where the researchers have reviewed primary research that already exists. These might be literature reviews, systematic reviews, meta-analyses. They are reviewing the existing research data to bring that together to come to conclusions. Some of the articles are also informative articles on academic topics. Returning to think about research, this research can be qualitative. That means research that's been gathered by talking to people or gathering their perceptions via surveys or making observations, watching people and watching what their reactions are and discussing issues with participants in the survey. They're basically trying to find out perceptions and reactions and feelings about different topics. Quantitative data, however, is looking at a statistical analysis of numerical data. So that might be data that's gathered in a laboratory or by gathering numerical data from surveys or from looking at patient data or student data, that kind of result. There's also mixed methods research, where the researchers have used a combination of both qualitative and quantitative research. So as a student, how are you supposed to use journal articles? So the evidence that's presented within this research allows you to demonstrate that the points you're making in your academic writing are true. And this is you carrying out evidence-based practice. You might have learnt lots of things from your lectures, but when you write about them, you need to present the evidence to back that up. And the best way to do that is to find the research that has informed your subject area that that thing is true. They also allow you to compare evidence, because different research groups will come to different conclusions about the same topic, allowing you to make comparisons between them and the methods they've used, and make evaluations, judgments about which is most applicable to the topic you're writing about. You're also able to make critical points about the literature, about the research that you're using. So all research will have limitations. No piece of research is perfect. So you can identify those limitations and suggest why that might make a difference to the conclusion. It might be the sample size, for example. Maybe that's too small, and actually you could maybe make a suggestion that repeating the research with a larger group of participants would provide more robust data. You might also make critical points about the methods that have been used. They might have carried out surveys but not followed those up with interviews, for example. So that might not have been able to explore that topic in as much depth as you think they could have done. And this gives you an opportunity to demonstrate your critical thinking by highlighting these issues. Now, there needs to be a balance of the resources you're using. You might be thinking, okay, great, I'm just going to use journal articles now. I'm not going to use any other kind of resource. And that's not really going to be possible. It's a good idea to try and have one third books, one third journal articles, and a one third of other resources. So that might be web pages, reports, videos, lecture notes, etc. You will need, of course, to use official websites that are related to your subject, and there will be key books that are on your reading list that your lecturers will be expecting you to refer to. And then the journal articles that you find via library search will enhance and support those other resources. So I bet you're raring to go now to find these journal articles. So how can you do that? The best place to start is by looking on library search. So go to the library homepage, where there is a library search box right there at the top. Put in your keywords. I've put social media marketing in inverted commas into my search here. I filtered that by journal articles, and I've got a number of articles that are talking about social media marketing. You can also try Google Scholar, but be aware that you won't have access to everything, whereas you will via library search. And you can also look at the library databases. There is an A to Z databases link at the top of library search and at the top of the library homepage to allow you access to that. So explore that, look at your subject area and the databases that are recommended to you. So in summary, journal articles are basically academic magazine articles. Hopefully that makes them feel a bit more accessible to you. They're reporting on academic research, so some of the language may be a little bit advanced, certainly as when you're starting your degree, but getting used to that as early as you can is going to help you to use them as you go through. So you can and should be using journal articles to evidence your written work from as early as possible. You can find journal articles using library search, the library databases, or Google Scholar. Search for keywords related to your topic, and if you're using library resources, filter by journal article. If you're not sure how to do those things, we have lots of videos within our YouTube playlists on how to use library search and our other resources. So continue exploring the YouTube playlists as soon as you finish watching this video.